Yay! What's up, Mom Nation?
Woohoo!
Woohoo! We're back. Sorry, we're a little late. Usually we are on these live and learns at 11:30 on Thursdays. That's our typical schedule. But you know, technology sometimes gets weird, right, Kara?
Yep, sure does.
So speaking of Kara, welcome back to the show. We've had you on, I think, a couple of times in the past, but never about this topic. So I'm really excited to dive into it.
Yeah, this is really cool. So we're going to talk about anxiety and some emotional, spiritual issues today. And I'm going to introduce you to another tool that we use here in the office at Taking Care of Women. It's called Quantum Biofeedback. So at Taking Care of Women, we work with women that are dealing with burnout, fatigue, mystery illnesses. And we also work with women that are looking to balance their hormones naturally. We don't do any HRT or anything like that, but we do it with stress reduction. So this is one of the tools that we use for stress reduction, and it's called the life system. And what it does is it identifies stress patterns in the body, and then it actually brings them back into balance. So Katie, have we done a biofeedback session on you yet?
We have. When I was in your office earlier this year, you actually helped me out quite a bit. So I appreciate that. Thank you. We did a hair analysis and we did the biofeedback, which was pretty cool.
Perfect. So the way that I explain biofeedback is kind of like everybody's born with an empty cup. So in the beginning of our life, we have, you know, a blank slate pretty much. And as we go through our life, more and more dramas and traumas and issues come up, and they start to kind of like accumulate in that cup. And I always think of it kind of like a reservoir, right? Of how much you can handle. And so when you have that empty cup, you know, some people our cup overflows when we're 5 or 6. But for a lot of people, it doesn't overflow until we get to college. We're, you know, studying, we're working, we're, you know, overdoing ourselves. And so eventually at some point in life, that cup is going to overflow. And a lot of women feel that in shortness, you know, short tempers, irritability, you know, anxiety, hormonal imbalances, weight gain. And we don't necessarily go, oh, I'm just stressed. It's what's wrong with me. And then that adds to the stress, right?
Right.
So with biofeedback, what it's doing is it's saying, you know, what level are you at? How high are you? How much stress has, you know, started to weigh you down, and how many things are bothering you that are adding to your physical ailments? And number one, let's identify them. And number two, let's start to remove them. So there are a lot of testing systems. Muscle testing is a form of biofeedback. A thermometer is a form of biofeedback. And so this system, what it does is it's frequency based. So Katie, if I say to you volleyball, and you don't have any stress reaction to the word volleyball, your body's not going to react to that. But if I say to somebody breast cancer, and either they've lost somebody to it, or they're afraid of having it, or maybe they already had it, your nervous system is going to respond to just that frequency, because everything in the universe carries a frequency. Sometimes it's a high vibrational frequency, like unconditional love or joy. And sometimes it's a really, really low negative vibrational frequency, like illness and cancers and death and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So what we do with biofeedback is we use it in conjunction with the hair analysis to really kind of pinpoint physical stress, emotional stress, and spiritual stress. But then we can also give you the opposite frequency to bring you back into balance and start to remove some of that stress off of your soul. So Katie, do you want me to share this screen and show you the test I just did?
Yeah, please do.
Okay. So this is something called the reactivity panel. And this is a this is testing for 7,000 frequencies in approximately 6 minutes. Now we can do this in distance, but we do also do it here in the office. And so there are going to be things that are stressors for you, and they're all categorized over here by color. So you can see that there are some things that are like, these are homeopathic remedies. This is an emotional healing remedy. This is an allergen. So this is a pollen allergen. It'll show sinuses are an issue, testosterone, maybe an allergy to celery. So you can see how it's multifaceted. It's really looking at everything that you're stressed out by physically. So organs, glands, adrenals, digestive issues, but also emotional attributes. So if we click on willow, this one is for resentment and the feeling that life is unfair. One may also resent the cheerfulness of others, teaches one to take responsibility for their own life. So there are things that will resonate with people and they're like, oh my gosh, like that's totally me. Or I could see how that would come up. And then from here, we can actually customize the treatment based off of what we're looking for and how we want to balance you. So something so simple as like chakras or energy pathways, when our energy pathways get out of balance, that will affect our body physically, spiritually, and emotionally. And you know, some people aren't into the whole like spiritual side of it, but the reality of it is if there's any energy, a flow of energy that's blocked in your body, physically, you're going to have issues with that. So I tend to start with opening up energy pathways first, and then I go into the physical healing, because the physical healing, you know, is always going to be a side effect of a blocked energy pathway. And as you can see, I'm testing myself in distance right now. I do this pretty frequently. There's only one chakra that's blocked. And so we can see in correlation to the chakras that are blocked, any physical ailments that you might have, like maybe constipation or bloating or gas or any uterus issues. And then you can also look for things that are very, very physical, like hormones. So we can test your hormones in here. It's looking for, you know, an imbalance in highs and lows. But this is kind of one of the tools that we use to help with anxiety when people are dealing with, you know, that fight or flight state and that high anxiety.
And I feel like this does not get enough attention, mm-hmm. because what I've learned over the 100 bazillion years that I've been on the planet now is that oftentimes those spiritual things that you were talking about, those energetic mm-hmm. things, are going to manifest themselves in a physical ailment. Can you speak a little bit about that?
And yeah, I mean, one of the founders of emotions getting trapped in the body is Louise Hayes. And she actually just passed probably about 2 years ago. She's written multiple books, started the Hay House, a publishing company for, you know, people like Gabby Bernstein and Anthony William and,
Abraham Hicks, I think, is under Hay House. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yep. And so when she was younger, I can't remember if she had cervical or ovarian cancer, but, she ended up being diagnosed with a terminal cancer. And she basically was like, I'm not going to do any sort of traditional medicine. I'm going to heal myself naturally. And one of the things that she realized was all the sexual abuse trauma that she had had from her young adulthood had kind of stored itself in her uterus. And you know, it's toxic. And when we do like guided meditation and Reiki and all the other modalities that we do here, everything physical is related to something emotional. So for example, the left shoulder, if you have pain in the left shoulder, or you have like a tear or a strain, the left shoulder is related to family stress. So if you're, you know, having a bad relationship with your husband, or you're worried about your mom being put into a home, or your kids struggling at school, your left shoulder can flare up. Your feet are about moving in the right direction. If you're questioning your path in life, your back is about feeling supported. Your hips are about not feeling like you're accepting of the situation or something that's going on in your life right now. So we can look at all aspects of healing. We look at the physical components of it with the hair analysis, but it will show when emotions are a stressor for your body. And then we can come into here and we can look at, we can test any organ that we want to. We can test any hormones. We can test any acupuncture points, brain waves. We can look for ADD and ADHD. But then we also have, you know, the spiritual aspects of it. Like we have the chakras and the auras and the acumeridians, and we even have a past life portal. We can balance you spiritually on all 12 dimensions, because everything comes together. So, you know, traditional medicine is just going to look at that single plane of Western medicine, you know, organs, physical ailments, drugs, stuff like that. And likewise, you know, I always say you can't, you know, Reiki yourself out of adrenal burnout, you know,
right.
Like it can't just be one modality or the other. Like there's going to be times where you need supplementation and you need diet and you need physical healing, but you also need to do it in conjunction with emotional and spiritual healing as well. So this is just a quick organ example. So it'll show up the organs and it'll show which organs have the most stress. And then we can also test emotions in emotional panels. So I typically don't do this one right away because we don't want to add to people's emotional stress. So once I know their nervous system is calm and safe, then I'll come in here and test. But there's about 400 frequencies in here that it's going to test for. So you'll see things like apprehension, avoidance, bargaining, betrayal, change in personality, compassion. Now, Katie, if I asked you, like, how are you feeling today? You might be like, I'm a little sad, but you wouldn't categorize it or articulate it as longstanding grief.
Right.
Right. Or you might ask a mom, you know, what's going on? Oh, I'm a little stressed, but desire to run away shows up, you know? And so it really is a conversation with your subconscious that brings to light the subconscious belief systems and the subconscious ideas that we have about our stressors. And as it starts to bring that to light, you can process that with your counselor. You can process that with your husband. You can process that with your friends. But the cool thing is that you don't even have to talk for us to clear it for you. So again, it's taking the stuff out of, you know, that overflow capacity. It's taking that stuff out of the cup and allowing your body to get to a state where you have a little bit of reserves. And so with anxiety and hormonal imbalances and stuff like that, what we're looking at is are you even in a safe enough space to heal yourself? Because when your body is in that fight or flight state, that nervous system state of high alert, it's survival mode. So your digestion shuts down, your immune system shuts down, and your nervous system isn't in a place of regeneration. It's in a place of just keeping you alive and just keeping you going. So how effective do you think your healing is going to be when you're doing all these things to move yourself forward, but your nervous system isn't even activated properly? And that's a lot of the times where like anxiety and stuff comes from. So I'm going to just touch on, let me get to the brain panel. I'm going to touch on the HPA axis. I'll just test these while I'm talking. So whenever we perceive a threat, our hypothalamus, which is in our brain, it's right behind our nose and eyes, our hypothalamus will register that as a threat and send hormones to the pituitary gland. Pituitary gland sends hormones to the adrenals, and the adrenals release adrenaline and cortisol. And we call this the HPA axis. I know I get super nerdy about stuff like this.
I love it.
But the HPA axis is our stress response. So once the adrenals release adrenaline and cortisol, that is that surge. You ever like almost rear end somebody and you're like, oh my gosh, like all of a sudden you have a ton of energy and you're wide awake, even though you were falling asleep before.
Yeah. And it's like warm and it's almost like that prickly sensation all throughout my body and in my extremities is how I feel.
That tingling, that circulation, because if you were to fight or flee, you would need all of those functions. Your muscles would have to contract. You would have to breathe deeper. Your heart rate would have to increase. You'd have to see better and you'd have to be able to run faster. The problem in today's society, though, is while that you that makes perfect sense.
The ADD being you're testing 90. Yourself.
Yeah. So what happens is we are supposed to use those hormones to run or to fight. But what do we do when we are stressed? We just sit in it, right? So that adrenaline and cortisol gets surging through our body, then it gets dumped in our liver where it burdens our liver and takes away from functions that the liver should do, like metabolize fat and pull glucose for energy and break down proteins into branched chain amino acids and all these other things that the liver is supposed to do. And so when your brain is constantly overactive and it's constantly firing in that fight or flight state, you're never in a state of rest and regeneration, and you have to be there in order to heal. Another thing that fight or flight response does and that HPA axis does is it actually shuts down production of TSH or thyroid stimulating hormone, because that's a secondary function, right? So I always tell people thyroid is a stress disease. If you manage your stress, you'll never have thyroid problems. But as women, we take on this stress and then we push and push and push some more and then we take on another stress. So I always try to have people think about their energy and their, you know, emotional capacity being like your budget. If you run at 100% of your max capacity for energy or for your budget, what happens when you need 4 new tires? You can't handle it because you don't have it.
Right.
So when you lower that stress to about 60, 70%, when you have something that happens that's traumatic or sad or scary or needs your attention, you have all that space to handle it. When we get short-tempered and we start having anxiety and hormone imbalances and thyroid dysfunction, it's because we've functioned in this overflowing level for so long that our body is just keeping us alive. And it's so amazing that it fights so hard for us. And that's one of the things I always want women to take away, is that don't be mad at your body. It really is your environment that's putting you there. If you know, your body just fights for us constantly to just keep us going. And it's just crucial that we nourish that and get out of that fight or flight state every once in a while.
I feel like this is the answer to that missing link that, you know, women often find. I just talk with a lot of women, a lot of moms. So I use them, you know, as example all the time, but I hear constantly, I don't feel well, I'm sick, I'm this, I'm that. I go to the doctor, he says, there's nothing wrong with me.
Yeah.
This is the answer to that.
I mean, and stress reduction. I mean, you can call it self-care, you can call it biofeedback. This is one tool out of many, but what I love about it is that it identifies where you need attention. And you know, the hair analysis does that physically, but this does that spiritually and emotionally. And the other thing that this will do is, Katie, have you ever had a time where you're like, I think that this might be off. Like, I think that this is wrong. And you kind of ignore it. It's in the back of your head, but you kind of, you know, you think about it often. And then 6 months, 8 months, 9 months go by, and then something dramatic happens. And now you have to get, like, maybe your hormones, or maybe you have a virus or something like that. You mm-hmm. have to pay attention to it, because now it's so bad, you can't ignore it anymore. That's what ends up happening, is women intuitively, we just have this innate ability to connect with our bodies, but we need external validation to believe it. We all have that intuition, and we're all usually right, but we need somebody else to tell us that we're right for whatever mm-hmm. reason. Mm-hmm. And so when a woman sits in the chair and they say, I've just been feeling like, you know, like really angry and really resentful and this and that and the other thing. And then we run their acu meridians, and you see like the liver meridian and the gallbladder meridian show up, which house anger and resentment or bitterness. And you see their chakra show up, and it's around their sacral chakra, which is their uterus. And that's your intimate relationships. And you know, they're upset with their husband, or they're holding on to something that they haven't let go of yet. Everything in their body, whether it's an organ, a gland, a chakra, an acu meridian, a spine, like a vertebrae, all of our vertebrae are connected to specific emotions too. Wow. Even dental's related to organs and emotions. It's the coolest thing. So when everything in the system validates their feelings, they leave here feeling heard. They leave here feeling validated. They leave here feeling super calm. And then they leave here feeling like they have a plan, and that it's something that they can actually work on.
Which I love. Oh. And that's something mm-hmm. that I experienced. And, you know, one thing that you shared with me when I went in and I had this done, had the hair analysis and all of that, which again, I've been around for 100 million years, and this is like the first time I'd had this conversation with somebody, is your body's ability to relieve itself of toxins and how much that causes stress. Mm-hmm. I'm going to specifically bring up poop. Okay. I said it. And, you know, we had that conversation, and you point blank asked me, well, how many times a day do you go? And I'm like, once, doesn't everyone? And you're like, oh, no. So can you talk a little bit about that? Because that was fascinating to me. And I feel like people don't understand that they need to sweat and they need to excrete, and like that system is in there for a reason.
Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, a lot of the part of anxiety comes back down to stress. And when you're stressed and your body's releasing the adrenaline and cortisol, if you don't move, then it ends up being dumped in your liver. Now, your liver is your filtration system. And part of the problem with weight loss and immune issues and sickness and virus and chronic mystery illnesses and brain dysfunction is that the liver can't move toxins out because it's too bogged down with all the other crap that it has to deal with. So if you live a pretty clean life, and you know, you're healthy and you eat clean and you don't do fragrances and toxins and cleaning products and stuff like that, but you're really, really stressed, it's just as bad. I always say a happy alcoholic is healthier than a sad, healthy person. Yeah. Because if you think about, like, you might have a drink 2 or 3 times a week, but if you have 30 stress responses throughout the entire day, your liver is just on overdrive trying to clear those out. One of the things I teach my women to do is that when you feel that stress response flare up, just do some jumping jacks or push-ups or squats. And it's like, you'll be fighting with your husband. You're like, don't mind me. Just over here burning off some cortisol. That's just kind of a joke, but But when your liver is overburdened, it has to move out toxins. And so its job is to clean up the blood. And if it can't do its job, then the blood doesn't get filtered. Now there's four detox pathways: your liver, your breath, poop, pee, breath work, and skin. So sweat. Mm-hmm. Now, most of us, we know drinking water is important. So a lot of us are pretty good in that area. But yeah, if you poop once a day or less, that's considered constipated. Mm-hmm. So you should move food out 18 hours after you eat it. An easy way to test this is to just eat some corn or beets or blueberry powder or something.
You'll know when that comes out.
And then just check. Yeah, just check throughout the day and see how long it takes. We also want people sweating regularly. So, a lot of times when people don't sweat, that's a good sign that their lymphatic system is blocked. So they're not moving out toxins well. And then breath work is really important. So that's why, you know, exercise is so crucial, because you get the sweat, you get the detox through the skin, but then you also are increasing your heart rate. So you're breathing more. But when it comes to toxins and stress, the more stress hormones are dumped into the liver, the less functional the liver is going to be. And that's going to lead to hormonal imbalances, weight gain, poor fat metabolism, cortisol increase, you know, weight gain around the waist and the hips. So it's just crucial.
And so what I'm, also hearing in there, just a little sort of piece I wanted to pull out is, you know, a lot of times, especially here in Arizona, we wear antiperspirant. Sounds like maybe that's not the best idea.
So there's a lot of things wrong with deodorants and antiperspirants, heavy metals being number one. There's aluminum in them. You put them on the one area where your pores open the most and it sweats the most. So they're getting absorbed. And then the other problem with it is usually fragrances, which are endocrine disruptors. So hormone imbalances can be related to anxiety and depression and mm-hmm. weight gain, irritability and insomnia, night sweats, and all the other fun things that we deal with as women. So the best way to do that would be like a cleaner one. So like Loom makes one, Native makes one, Schmitz makes one. They're fragrance-free, they're aluminum-free. Beauty Counter has one. So just looking into cleaning up your products, and that's probably a good segue into anxiety, right? A lot of the times when women come to me with anxiety, there's a couple different factors that play in. Number one, stress, which is the overflow of this, of the, you know, overflow of stress and environmental factors that can cause fight or flight. And when a woman gets, and men included, but when people get stuck in fight or flight, they become sympathetic dominant, which is what I call it, when they can't come down. So they're always in go mode. They're always thinking. Their mind is always going. They need sleeping pills to help them fall asleep at night, or they need a drink to help them fall asleep at night because their mind just doesn't shut off. They're not coming out of that high stress state and into a regenerative state. And that's what biofeedback does. Biofeedback will actually put you into the parasympathetic state manually, which is why people feel almost like they're kind of like head high afterwards, because they're so calm, it's foreign to them. They sleep 10 to 13 hours a night, like right after that, it's amazing. But when another thing that will contribute to that is hormone imbalances, which can be caused by stress. And mm-hmm. it can also be caused by our environment, like fragrances and endocrine disruptors in our products. But typically, if you have a low progesterone range, you are susceptible to anxiety, depression, bipolar, and even schizophrenia on the more, you know, farther spectrums.
Right.
And a lot of people don't realize that, you know, these 15, 16 year old girls that are going through puberty that are having bad periods, and their doctors put them on birth control because now they have depression, or they've been diagnosed as bipolar, or they have anxiety, when none of that happened before their period. And you test their progesterone levels, these 16 year old girls have progesterone levels lower than 70 year old women.
Wow.
And it's because of all these fragrances and the candles and the Bath and Body Shop and all the products that we put on ourselves that have estrogen boosting chemicals. So our progesterone becomes super deficient, and you go to a doctor and they're just going to want to put you on some sort of anti-anxiety medication because they're not trained to look at hormones as the issue. Mm-hmm. And so we use an essential oil blend or a serum. Sometimes we can use a progesterone cream, but since finding the oil blend, I like that better. And it's just natural ways to increase progesterone, but it's also about educating women on stress management, how they can eliminate some of that in their life, and then how they can you know, I can't necessarily say treat because I'm not a doctor, but how they can change their lifestyle to make sure that these symptoms improve.
Totally agree. So I know the burning question out there right now is, what is it like when I walk through the door and I meet with you, Kara? So can you kind of go over a little bit about that, a typical appointment might be like?
Sure. I'm going to share my screen, or I'm not going to share my screen. I'm going to show you right now the room.
We're going on a field trip.
An idea. Because what you'll see the TV.
Can you see the TV? Oops, I can't hear you anymore. I can see the TV, but
can you hear me?
I lost you. There you are.
Okay, good. I think the microphone's on the bottom of the computer. So.
Oh.
and then you just.
So I see the chairs. So we would come in, and I think that's the biofeedback chair, right?
Yes, that's the biofeedback chair. So it's a recliner, and you just kick back and get comfortable on rainy days like it is over here. Today we have a blanket. So we really just try to pamper you and just make you feel like you're kidless and supported, and you're the one being taken care of now instead of being the one taking care of everybody. And so you just come in, we put this harness on you right here, and it's very beautiful. And everybody always likes to take pictures with the
sexy headband.
It leaves nice little dots on your forehead when you're done. It's got these LED lights on the inside. And so what it's doing is it's testing your sensitivity to the frequencies that show up in the system. And so when we do that, we share the screen with you so that you can see everything that's coming up. And some people like to talk. Most of the women like to talk. They want to process stuff while they're here, but some people like to just rest and have us work on them. So we'll just put some meditation music on them and just have them relax. And the cool thing about it is that we can make you feel really good, and we can get a lot done without having any conversation. So we have three types of sessions. We have an in-person session, which you get the most out of because it's stronger when it comes from the box than it is when it's in distance.
Gotcha.
But we also do them in distance on Zoom. So we have clients all over the country. And then we also have a session where we'll work on you and send you a report. So a lot of my entrepreneur, interior designer, you know, international business owners, a lot of them just say, you know, this is what I need, work on me and send me the report. And so we'll work on them, and they always notice a difference. So it's just a self-care maintenance program of keeping that stress level down so that you can keep, you know, keep going and doing your life the way that us busy moms do.
Yeah. I love that. And I also love that you helped me develop a plan of how to move forward in, you know, a less stressful manner and kind of address some of those issues that I had specifically.
That's a big part of it. I mean, we have a big poster in our front room, and we have the symptom on the triangle at top, and then the nervous system is in the middle, but your environment regulates your nervous system. So we want to teach you how to analyze your environment, look at the things that are bringing you the most amount of stress, get rid of the things that aren't. And then that will heal your nervous system. And then the nervous system will heal the pain and the symptoms. So.
Awesome. I love it. Well, I have your Facebook fan page posted here in the show notes.
Awesome. Thank you.
But is there anything else that you would like to share, or any specific ways to contact or connect with you?
Just, you can either go to the website, which is takingcareofwomen.com. And you can click on the biofeedback link. We actually have an intro to biofeedback session, which is only $75. So if you want to try it once and just kind of like get your feet wet and see what it feels like, that way, you know, they're normally $125. So it's just a good way to try that one out. And then on September 30th, we're going to have an open house, and we're going to do mini sessions of everything. So we usually do like a crystal reading or a chakra reading, in those mini sessions too. So yeah, our website has all of our booking information and everything like that, or they can reach out on Facebook.
Fun. Well, thank you so much. I absolutely love your office, and I need to pay a visit because it's been a little while since I came to see you.
We're always here.
Well, thank you again for being with us. Thank you for all of that information. I know we blew a few minds out there. So if you guys are interested in getting connected with Kara, definitely click on the Facebook fan page link that I have here in the show notes. Get connected with her. I promise it will be life-changing. It certainly was for me. If you are interested in any of our past shows, you want to connect with all of our playlists, we do a lot of shows here, and we really talk about a lot of things, all women mama related. go on over to our YouTube page, and that is at MOMnation USA. That is our handle. Or if you prefer the podcast, you know, maybe a hike a lot, bike a lot, that kind of thing, you like it in your ears better, or do what I do when I'm folding laundry. That's when I listen to my podcasts, right? Pop on over to your favorite podcast platform, do a quick search for MOMnation Talk Radio, and you will connect with all of our shows there. Thank you so much for being with us, Kara.
Thanks, Katie.
Bye, guys.